Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to see what is meant by scaling and various scale-up criteria for a given bioreactor system. Scale-up is defined as study of problems associated with the transfer of experimental data from laboratory and pilot plant equipment to large-scale industrial equipment. So basically, whatever products we are manufacturing at lab scale, we should be able to get the same yield of products when we are scaling it up to a plant scale as well as into a commercial scale. So in other words, whatever relationship between parameters involved are established in lab scale experiments, the same relationship must be developed when we scale it up to pilot or industrial scale. An ideal scale-up criterion is that parameter which has the same numerical value as the values of the geometrically similar bioreactors increase in size. So basically, by this we mean that whatever scale-up criteria we are selecting, it should be selected in such a way that it has the same value when we compare it in lab scale, pilot scale, or commercial scale. The condition here will be that the reactors, when we are taking it in lab scale, pilot scale, or commercial scale, it should be geometrically similar in size. Now, by geometrically similarity, we mean that the H by D ratio of all the reactor systems must be same, or it must remain constant. So let us take the lab scale. HL1 is the height of the given reactor, and DT1 is the diameter of the given reactor. Similarly, for pilot scale, HL2 and DL2 are the height and diameter of the pilot scale reactor. And for commercial scale reactor, HL3 and DT3 are the height and diameter respectively. So when we are choosing the scale-up criteria, the reactors should be of geometrical similarity. So HL1 by DT1 should be equal to HL2 by DT2, and that should be equal to HL3 by DT3, and so on. So let us take an example for scale-up. For a given medium composition, temperature, and pH, our objective is to maximize the cell yield factor, which is nothing but yield of biomass with respect to substrate. So let us start with a 10-liter laboratory scale bioreactor unit, and we perform optimization experiments at different volumetric rates of oxygen supply, which is expressed as capital R. The volumetric flow rate of oxygen is given as a diffusion equation where the driving force is concentration difference. Here KLA is known as the volumetric mass transfer coefficient of oxygen. YX bar S, as already mentioned, it is yield of biomass with respect to substrate. So using the 10 liter laboratory scale bioreactor, let us assume that we run a number of experiments and we get a hypothetical data. When we plot the data, take the data and plot a graph between yield and R, let us assume that we are getting a linear plot which becomes constant after some point. Now the question here is, when we scale up to 50,000 liter bioreactor system, are we going to get the same yield versus R relationship? It depends on what scale up criteria we use when we go from 10 liters to 50,000 liters bioreactor system. If the volumetric rate of oxygen transfer, which is expressed as R, were a true scale-up criterion, then the relationship between Y versus R shown in figure 2 for the 10-liter bioreactor should be exactly the same for any bioreactor size. So for example, let us consider that we perform experiments for various sizes of bioreactors like 10-liter, 10,000 liter, 1000 liters, 50,000 liter, and so on, and we get a kinetic data, and from the data we plot a graph between yield and R. And if R were to be a true scale-up criterion, we will be getting a similar pattern of plot what we got for 10 liter bioreactor system. So in this graph we can see that for almost all sizes of bioreactor we are getting the same pattern of graph. That means it is increasing, yield is increasing with respect to R up till some point, and after that it is becoming a constant. So if this is to be the case, whatever scale up criteria is selected, that happens to be the true scale up criterion. But in reality, scale up of laboratory and pilot plant data to commercial size industrial bioreactors is very difficult and complicated. No actual data or correlation exists for scale up. Different people use different scale up criteria to design commercial size bioreactor systems. Also in industry, there are a lot of trade secrets on scale up of bioreactors and very few published results exist in the literature. Now take a couple of minutes, pause the video and ponder on this question. Can you list some of the reasons for scaling up of a process to be difficult, especially the bioprocess industries? I hope you have taken some time to list down the reasons for making the scale-up process to be a difficult process. The most common reasons that is observed in industries for scaling up is there is no specific protocols for scale-up. So the protocols for scale-up vary from industry to industry. It will be different for chemical industries, it might be different for service industries, it might be different for pharmaceutical industries and so on. So there is no obvious protocol or generalized protocol for scaling up. So it is merely based upon trial and error experiments. There is no common techniques involved. So basically, there is no common rule or guidelines or techniques which can be followed and you can arrive at a typical true scale up criteria and just as it is, go ahead and scale up the process. And if you take a typical bioprocess or a fermentation process, there are a lot of components which are involved in bioprocess which has to be taken care of. Because of the involvement of all these various components in the fermentation process or industrial biotechnological process, it makes it more complex. Now let us consider a stir tank reactor setup, which is the most commonly used bioreactor in any kind of bioprocess manufacturing industry. So this is the typical design of a stir tank reactor. Let us assume that HL is the height of the reactor and DT is the diameter of the reactor and N is the rotational speed of the impeller and DI is the diameter of the impeller. Let us assume that it is an aerobic process and Q is the volumetric flow rate of air which is sparged inside the reactor. Now when we have to choose a scale-up criteria for a process running inside the stir tank reactor, in general, it is taken as a function of all these independent variables what we have discussed now. It can be rotational speed of the impeller, it can be impeller diameter, it can be tank diameter, it can be height of the reactor, or it can be volumetric flow rate, or it can be any property of the fluid which is participating in the reaction. Several people use several different scale-up criteria. Once a criteria is selected, then you make sure that the numerical value of the scale-up criteria is the same for small as well as large-sized bioreactor. So in general, scale-up criteria for a small bioreactor must be equal to scale-up criteria for a large bioreactor. So for example, if we select the volumetric mass transfer coefficient KLa to be the scale-up criteria, then we must make sure that KLa value which was observed in small bioreactor should be equal to KLa in large bioreactor. Now coming to the different important dependent variables used in scale-up, there are many, but we'll stick to the stir tank reactor for the time being. So some of the scale-up criteria which are used for stir tank bioreactors are agitation power, which is represented as P. So if we see the relationship between power number and agitation power, the power number is given as P divided by N cubed DI to the power 5. So when we observe that equation, we get a relationship between P, N and DI, and that is P proportional to N cubed DI to the power 5. And let me remind you, N is the rotational speed of the impeller and DI is the impeller diameter. The rate of liquid pumping by the impeller is represented by RL. This is yet another scale-up criteria which is frequently used for a stir tank reactor. And VL is the volume of the liquid that is pumped. VL is directly proportional to the DI cube. And RL is directly proportional to N into VI cube. So since VI is directly proportional to DI cube, when we correlate these equations, we get a relationship as RL is proportional to proportional to n into diq. Yet another parameter is ungassed power per unit liquid volume delivered by the impeller. It is represented as P by VL. So already we have seen a relationship for P as well as VL. So P is proportional to n cube di to the power 5. And as I told you, VL is directly proportional to di cube. So when we correlate this, we get P by VL is directly proportional to n cube di square. Impeller tip velocity, which is represented as Vt, is given as pi into n into di. So from that equation, we get a proportionality equation as Vt is proportional to n into di. Another very important parameter which can be used as a scale-up criteria is impeller Reynolds number. And Reynolds number for an impeller is given as n di square rho by mu. And from that equation, we get a relationship as Reynolds number is directly proportional to n di square. So we can see by all these relationships that the given scale-up criteria that can be chosen is related to either impeller diameter di or rotational speed n. So if we vary one or both the parameters, you will have a great impact on the scale-up criteria, and eventually it will be having a great impact on the scale-up process too. So we should vary the n and di and the related parameters in such a way that the scale-up criteria happens to be the same in lab as well as commercial scale processes. Thank you.